The SEC does not represent the views of the SEC. Yes, that's right. After the SEC responded by saying that the views of the sitting chairs on the SEC don't represent the SEC, Ripple came back with a response from Brad and Chris in their respective case against the SEC. And it's pretty much all but a nail in the coffin in terms of the SEC's case against these two executives. But I'm going to be talking about how Brad and Chris, the executives of Ripple, actually responded to the SEC as the SEC continues to paint themselves into a corner. In another crypto news, the CEO of Twitter and Square was recently on a financial call where he told JP Morgan some big news that Twitter has for involving Bitcoin, payment systems, and artificial intelligence. I'm going to tell you what he said about Bitcoin and why he is so bullish on it, and the views that he has on cryptocurrency and how they do or don't match up with Twitter's values. Hey everyone, my name is Randy. Welcome back to the Late Night Grind. Right now on this channel, I'm covering the Ripple versus SEC case, as well as other cryptocurrency news and investment markets, as well as personal finance. So if any of those topics interest you and you want to follow along, make sure you hit the subscribe button. All you got to do is click that little button. Make sure you hit the bell notification icon. That way YouTube will send you a notification when I release a new video. And if you're new to the channel and you're feeling really generous, I'd greatly appreciate it if you join on my current subscriber base and hit the thumbs up button. It really helps out with the YouTube algorithm, helps out with a somewhat of a newer YouTube channel like this. Just tells YouTube to share this video with new audiences. So if you do that, I'd greatly appreciate it. All right, guys, well, let's jump into it. So I'm going to start off with Jack Dorsey and his call and what his plans are for involving Bitcoin with Twitter and Square. He was actually on a call, a financial call with investors, namely JP Morgan was on the call, and he was talking about a couple of things, things such as revenue, year-over-year revenue, things like that. But he specifically mentioned that their long-term plans involved things like Bitcoin and a few other things. Later in the call, the representative from JP Morgan asked him to reiterate or expand on his thoughts on Bitcoin and how it could be incorporated into Twitter. Well, Jack went on to say that he believes that Bitcoin should essentially be the internet's native currency. Now, I thought that was a really interesting take because so many people, when they think about digital currencies or Bitcoin and things like that, when they think about it being a replacement currency or a reserve currency, it could be those things. But I think Jack is actually onto something when he's calling it the internet's native currency, meaning anything digital. So not that Bitcoin would actually be the currency of buying and selling in physical stores, in goods and services and things like that, but that it would be essentially the internet or the digital communications way of transferring money or value from place to place or even holding value. Now, I'm interjecting some of my opinions into what Jack was actually saying, but basically he was saying that Twitter wants to involve both AI along with Bitcoin and several other things into the future of Twitter, essentially using Twitter so that businesses could start issuing things like content, like paid content, like subscription models, things like tips for creators, among many, many other things, including commerce. So I thought that was really interesting because if a company like Twitter would actually do that, if something like YouTube would actually incorporate that and would incorporate cryptocurrencies as its form of native digital currencies, that would be huge for the ongoing value of the crypto space. Now, this comes right on the heels of Jack being part of the B Word, that Bitcoin conference where Elon Musk, Cathie Wood, and Jack all went on to discuss kind of their thoughts on Bitcoin and the crypto space are, as well as there were several other speakers on that conference as well. So as it stands right now, Twitter is attempting to be more on the forefront of this crypto movement. Now one of the biggest things that he did say was that he wants to make social media even more decentralized, which is really interesting because while I agree with Jack on the crypto space, it's interesting that he mentions that social media should be decentralized and that there shouldn't necessarily be a governing power. But that's essentially what Twitter and Facebook and YouTube do when they want to take certain topics down. Or if you discuss certain topics, take your channel down, deplatform you, demonetize you, things like that. It seems like there's a little bit of a two sides to the same coin that he's actually looking at. So from Twitter's perspective, I completely agree with where Jack wants to take that. But decentralizing social media, I'd really be interested into his thoughts on the future of that. And so as we move to the Ripple case, XRP is now looking like, in my opinion, could be the biggest beneficiary for this Bitcoin and crypto bull run that is now shaping up for the end of the year. There are some people that don't believe any of that's going to happen, that Bitcoin is going to continue to crumble, and that it's basically going to be in a several-year crypto winter until the next market cycle. I look at chart analysts literally every day, four, five, six of them that go over these charts and analyze things and analyze all kinds of things, not just price charts. That's only one of about 9 different charts that they go over. And so I'm pretty much sold on the fact that I believe that there's going to be a big crypto bull run by the end of the year. Bitcoin is going to lead that charge, but there's going to be a lot of other beneficiaries of it. And in my opinion, I think XRP could be one of the biggest beneficiaries of the entire crypto sector. Because by the end of the year, I believe this case will be over. I think the SEC continues to paint themselves into a hole, and it's going to shape up perfectly for XRP and for Ripple to receive that clarity that they've been looking for. Okay, so the update in the case. Well, so the SEC just replied to what Ripple presented to the judge a couple of days ago, where they said, listen, there's some sitting SEC attorneys that came out and literally said there is no clarity, or there's not enough clarity around rules and regulations in the crypto sector. The SEC then responded by saying, well, the views of SEC chairman don't exactly express the views of the SEC or its laws and regulations. Well, Ripple responded with a case against Brad Garlinghouse and Chris Larson, who the SEC is suing personally. They came back and replied and said, basically, nothing that your response came back with had any clarity. And in fact, you basically threw your own SEC chairman under the bus for even expressing their own opinions. Now, what's going to actually hold up in a court of law? Well, that's going to be up to Judge Netburn to decide. But in my opinion, looking at all this, it looks like the SEC continues to paint themselves into a corner because they say that what they say doesn't matter, even though it's what they're saying. Now, Jeremy Hogan on Twitter and James Filan have again been posting all of this and offering their opinions. Jeremy Hogan just tweeted out that he expects Ripple's response. Remember, this response was from the two executives. But he expects Ripple's response from the corporation to come shortly after, probably say some of the same things. Basically, that if your own sitting SEC chairs say that there is no clarity now, there couldn't possibly have been clarity 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 years ago, which your lawsuit claims that Chris Larson and Brad Garlinghouse knew and recklessly disregarded those securities laws. So you see how this is shaping up in Ripple's favor. So when you pair that with this massive upswing that I believe is going to happen towards the end of this year, I personally think XRP is going to be one of the biggest beneficiaries. I think Ethereum is also going to go huge, and really anything in the DeFi space is going to go huge. There are now articles, mainstream articles, talking about the billions of dollars that are now being pumped into the decentralized finance space, and many of these projects are going big. Let me know in the comment section below what your price predictions are for XRP at the end of the year. Now, when I say end of the year, I'm actually meaning February of 2022. Why? Because I believe the rest of this market cycle, the rest of this bull run, is not going to be complete until actually sometime in February. I know some of the models that show it being November, December, but this is an elongated market cycle. And a few of the chart analysts that I watch on a daily basis, many of them say the same thing. This is an elongated market cycle. But let me know in the comment section below what your price predictions are for February of 2022. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to visit the community tab. I will have a question on there about that. Normally my questions are in the form of surveys, so if you would go ahead and participate in that, I would greatly appreciate it. And once again, hitting that thumbs up button really helps out the channel. That's it for today, and I'll see you guys on the next video.